y'all, and welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to my channel. Okay, y'all, so I'm back, and I know I haven't been consistent as I wanted to be, but I got like a whole new schedule. Like literally every single day of my life is scheduled out to the T. So y'all finna be getting 2 videos a week, Tuesday and Thursday. So look out for that. And yeah, I hope y'all already been enjoying the content, but the content about to be just rolling out. So you can expect to see me now, which is great. And I'm coming out with a banger. This is for all the ladies, this is for all the baddies, because I know y'all want to grow y'all hair long. That's like a big thing, especially for my black girls. Like some girls think their hair can't grow, some people think it's because we black and our hair don't grow. That's not true. Everybody hair grows. It may grow differently, you may have shrinkage, but your hair can grow. You just have to take the time to love on it and figure it out and learn your hair. For today, we're gonna talk about how to grow your hair. This is the 7 things that help me grow my hair fast, quick, and easy. The hardest thing about this is staying disciplined, staying consistent, and not going outside of what I'm telling you to do for any reason. Okay, for any reason, you gotta buckle down for that year, 6 months, whatever it is, to make sure that you get the results that you're looking for. And yeah, like I said, this is not my real hair, but I will put pictures up. My hair went from like maybe like here to down here. It's probably even longer than that now. One thing about me, I'ma come with the receipts. Y'all see my hair stopping my shoulders, even the side is shaved. That's why it's hanging out like that, because it's shorter than all the rest of my hair. Then after taking care of it for just a couple of months, I got it to grow all the way down my back, and it's probably even longer than that now. And yeah, so that's a big thing. Make sure you take care of your hair under the weave and under these protective styles. It's not protective style if your hair under it is just dry and brittle and breaking off. So after going through that for so long, I got sick of that, and I'm just like, I need to go back to what I used to do, which is take care of my hair. I used to take care of my curls, and I haven't been doing that, and now that I'm doing that, I'm so happy. All right, y'all, so let's get into the nitty-gritty, what really grew my hair in literally just a few months. The first thing is low manipulation styles. You don't want to have, and let me explain what this is, because some people don't understand what low manipulation is. Low manipulation is not having strain on your hair, which includes ponytails, buns, tight braids, anything you could think of that is pulling your hair. You want your hair to like really just go freely and do its own thing. You don't want to be pulling on it or putting tight buns, especially for long hours. Like I know y'all go to school, y'all go to work in these tight buns. No, don't do it. For one, let me show you. Okay, I never ever put ponytails or buns in my hair unless I really need to. And even then, I put something like this on. Rubber bands and all that type of stuff will yank your hair out easily. Every time you take the rubber band out, you see all the hair around the rubber band, that hair has been yanked out. So you don't want to do that. Like you want very loosely, like this is how I would do my ponytail. No matter where I'm going, something loose, something that can damn near fall out, literally. Like, and you want a ponytail like this, which is satin, and it won't pull your hair out. But the other rubber bands, it'll pull your hair out. And manipulation can also mean constantly brushing your hair, constantly combing your hair, constantly doing your hair. Leave your hair alone. Pick a style, stick to it, and make sure it's not yanking or pulling on your hair. You don't have to do this forever. You just have to do this until you get the growth that you're looking for. The next thing is, which brings me to why the satin is so important, wear a bonnet at all times. What's also pulling out your hair and you do not realize it is your clothes. This. It all yanks your hair out. You don't want to lay your hair on anything that can yank it out. And you might think, oh, it's not yanking out that much. It is. It really is. Because it had been times I use bonnets, and there's times I haven't used my bonnets. And the time that I prioritize using a bonnet are the times that I notice the most growth and the least amount of breakage and stuff like that. And yeah, you just want to make sure you keep it in the bonnet at all times. The only time you should keep your bonnet off is when you are literally like actively doing something. Let's say you're going to a wedding. Don't take that bonnet off until you are walking into the doors of the wedding. Like, you really have to take it seriously. Bonnets at all times, scarves at all times, satin at all times. Because, like I said, it's pulling off from your clothes, places you sit, stuff you don't even realize. Like, your hair is being yanked 24/7, and especially to go to sleep. If you're not wearing a bonnet to sleep, I don't know what you're doing. Like, bonnets and scarves are not just to keep your hairstyle good. It's also to stop your hair from breaking. So utilize that literally as much as you possibly can. Okay, the next thing is water. Your hair is like a plant. And the water makes your hair grow. So make sure you don't be scared to put water on your hair. I know this might be hard for some girls because you might feel like the water is messing up your hairstyle or whatever it is, but like I said, it's buckle down time. You can't really be worried about like what your hair look like. Like, a big thing about growing your hair is realizing that you're not gonna have the cutest hairstyle all the time. You can get into wigs. This is a wig, and this is the only reason I bought this wig, is so that I could grow my hair out and don't have to worry about, like, you know, messing with my hair. I don't have to worry about manipulation. I don't have to worry about anything, because I could just throw a wig over it and that just be that. Do what you gotta do to your hair and put a wig on or a hat if you have to, but make sure you water your hair. Put some water on it, give it some love, and the water also helps the moisture get into your hair as well. The next thing is drink water and have a healthy diet. This is important just for your overall health and also to grow your hair. People don't realize it, but your hair is not growing and your skin is looking terrible because your diet is horrible. So really make sure you got a good diet going on. The next one is avoid heat. Avoiding heat, okay, the heat dries your hair out, and that's why I would say avoid heat, but heat can also be good for your hair. Some people don't know that. Heat can be good for your hair, and when my hair was the longest it's ever been years ago, I was straightening my hair every single week. But the thing that really helped me in that process is, for one, I had a routine. For two, I kept a bonnet on and I kept my scalp healthy. So that's why I was able to use heat like that. But at the same time, it's not really good for your curls. So, you know, and that's why I'm not trying to really go the heat route. Like, just stay away from heat as much as you can. You can do heat sometimes. You don't have to, like, never do heat. You can do heat sometimes because, like I said, sometimes heat can actually be good for your hair. But you don't want to do that all the time. You don't want to always be heat flat ironing it unless you got a set routine and you've listened to your hair and your hair allows you to do that to it. You get what I'm saying? I hope that makes sense. If you never spent real time with your hair and really focused on what is good and what's bad for your hair, then you probably won't understand what I'm talking about. But I'm telling you, now today, start to listen to it. See what it likes. See what it don't like. Your hair might not like heat. This person here might like heat. My hair liked heat when I had a set routine. And I wasn't flat ironing every day. I was flat ironing it like once a week or like once every 2 weeks. It was probably once every 2 weeks, but it was something like that. Like once a week or once every 2 weeks. The next thing is massage your scalp. So massaging your scalp is important because it promotes hair growth and it gets the blood flowing in your scalp. So that's simple, easy thing to do. Just make sure you massage it, put your oils and your greases and everything, and just massage your scalp just to promote that growth. You can get some stuff on Amazon that's scalp massagers. You could just do it yourself. It don't matter. Just make sure you get that blood flowing so that your hair can grow at a quicker rate. The next thing is, you might be doing all this stuff to your hair, but your hair is still not gonna grow unless you grease your scalp. Make sure your hair is moisturized, and also make sure your ends, the ends of your hair, is being moisturized and attended to. You have to take care of the ends of your hair because the ends of your hair has been with you the longest. It's the oldest part of your hair. So this is the part of your hair that needs the most attention, just like an old person. You don't know how long the ends of your hair been with you. It's been with you for a while and it needs extra attention, or it's going to just break off. And then the break is just going to come up and boom, you bald head all over again. So make sure you pay close attention to your ends. I know I'm talking a lot, but I mean, it's serious. Some people think that oil moisturizes your hair. Oil does not moisturize your hair. What oil does is lock in moisture. So put something on it to moisturize it. I prefer Vaseline. It's cleaner to me. It's very moisturizing. And it's good for me. You can use Blue Magic, but Blue Magic is just Vaseline with dye in it. So I will go straight to the source. That's what I do. The way I eat, the way I do anything, I always just go straight to the source. I don't want the cut corners. So I personally use Vaseline for my hair. I use it on my scalp. I use it on my hair, which means my hair gets tangled up and I have to be very, very careful with it. And I put it on my ends and it makes my hair super strong. I don't have to worry about breakage. I don't have to worry about any of that. My hair, I could blow dry it and it'd probably be two strands that fell out of it. If you're blow drying your hair and a lot of hair is coming out and you're thinking, oh, that's normal, it is not normal. The only time I can expect hair to come out of my hair is if it's been braids for a long time, because our hair breaks every day. There's nothing we could do about that, but you could lessen how much your hair breaks. So the Vaseline makes my hair super, super strong and I lose less hair than I would if I didn't use Vaseline. And that brings us to my next point, detangling. Detangling should take a long time. The longer your hair is, it should take even longer. Detangling, you shouldn't be, for one, I think everybody know, you start here and you come up. That's how you detangle. If you're starting to brush your hair or comb your hair from up here, you already got it all wrong. Throw that whole method away. Don't do that. Start from the ends and be patient. And I heard that you're not supposed to do your hair at nighttime, because when you're doing it at nighttime, you're rushing and you're trying to get through it. Detangling should take a long time. Detangling should take almost as much time as it would take to actually get your hair done. You have to literally love your hair that much to have a knot and not yank it out and you take it. You can, and finger detangling is even better. I haven't really graduated to that point yet. I don't finger detangle. I do use a comb, but I am super gentle. And if I feel a yank, I stop and I look and I take my time and I love on my hair. Finger detangle is even better. And if it is like a really big knot, I will finger detangle and I just pull it apart and I see what's the matter. And then I just easily untangle the knot, and that's how I detangle, and that's how you should be detangling. Because when you're yanking your hair, not only is that a lot of manipulation, it's a lot of breakage, it's just a lot going on, and your hair not gonna appreciate that. Okay, outside of that, make sure you cut your ends. When you don't cut your ends, you too scared to cut your ends, all it is doing is the breakage is coming higher and higher, and the higher the breakage is coming, now your hair is not healthy and now it's falling out. So make sure you snip it as much as it needs to be snipped. And yeah, that's all I have for y'all today. I'm pretty sure I have some more tips, especially for like curly hair, but that's all I'm gonna do today. I probably gave y'all like 8. I think I did like a bonus, and that was like the tangling. Make sure you detangle. If you just stick to this for, I'm gonna say, 6 months, I promise you, you will see a huge difference in your hair. And even after the first or second time you use Vaseline in your hair, you will notice the strength in your hair and how much less hair you lose when you detangle. And yeah, and how much less hair you lose when you detangle with care. So thank you so much for watching. Thank you for watching this video. I really hope this helps you all. And yes, have a nice night. Mwah.